The advantage of using a tool with a graphical interface is also that you can document your workflow inside the document itself. So, for example, under each node, you can write the task the node has been set to. Let's double-click what is written under the node, and let's write reading file data.table. And reading file data.table with a KNIME protocol. If that's not enough to describe what the workflow is doing or what a part of the workflow is doing, we can always create an annotation. Right-click anywhere in your workflow editor and then select New Workflow Annotation. This creates this kind of content that you can move around and place wherever you want, or you can edit through a double click. So, for example, you can write these two nodes read.table formatted files. And if you are artistically inclined, you can then have a title. You can select some part of the written and, for example, change the font, make it bigger, let's say 12, let's make it blue, and let's make it, for example, bold and italic because we want to exaggerate. So this is the kind of editing that you can do to your text. Another thing that you can change is the border. So again, double click, select border, and then you can make it bigger, let's say 25. And let's change color, let's make it red. Okay. Then you can make it bigger and you can put it around your nodes. When you are out of the editing mode, you can see this little cross here in the upper left corner. This is the cross that you need to double click or to select when you want to respectively edit or move the annotation.